What do I like about React? I must say it wasn't a laugh at the first sight. So I saw it and my first thought was, what did they smoke? What drugs do you have to take to come up with that idea? I'm Manuel Bieh. I'm a front-end developer specialized in React as a technology, building user interfaces with React, and I'm part of the Coder Society. Everyone always said you have to separate markup from behavior, don't put JavaScript into a HTML. So Facebook came and said, hey, let's not put JavaScript into the HTML, let's put the HTML into the JavaScript. No, you can't just put HTML into JavaScript. And they said, hey, yeah, of course we can do that. And it's awesome. And yeah, that's also the reason I think why many people are so skeptical at first when they see React. They see people putting HTML into JavaScript and they're all like, oh, wow, what are they doing? Are they crazy? But it really makes sense. If you work with it for a couple of hours and you play around with it a little bit, it makes so much sense because it makes user interface development so much easier. It's a library which you can use to build components with. So you can create encapsulated components where you say this is a menu button and you can use it in whatever project you want. So if you create this button once, you can use it everywhere. And that really makes it easy to share components between several projects. So if you build up a huge library of components, you can really quickly create new web applications with it. It makes it possible to just share components with others or make your components open source so that others can use it. And there's a really huge community around React with people who build really high quality components for React that you can just install into your project and don't have to worry about that. So that saves you hours and days and probably weeks of work that you would have usually done yourself. And that is what makes React really great. React will be around for quite some time now. If not React itself, then at least the principles and the paradigm of React. In the past, you usually used this so-called imperative approach, where you told the browser, hey, if I click the button, I want you to do that. And now with this declarative approach, you only say, when a button was clicked, I want the user interface to look like that. Do that for me. So you don't really tell the browser how to do things, but to just figure out how it needs to be done to get to a certain result. Yeah, so this was really new to web development and JavaScript development. And maybe there will be a better, more performant framework with a nicer syntax and make React obsolete eventually. But they will most certainly use the same approach. So I think React itself will also be around for at least probably 5 or 10 years,